أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. أما بعد، we have come to an end of the Ramadan fast, which Allah has commanded us to do, which is very important and is part of the pillars of Islam, as Allah has commanded us in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Quran chapter 2, verse 183, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykum siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. O you who believe, we have prescribed fasting for you as we have prescribed for those before you, so you attain piety. Alhamdulillah, we have come to an end to the Ramadan fast, which lasted for just the month of Ramadan, as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said in authentic hadith, including Sahih al-Bukhari, book number 30, hadith number 16. It says, لا تسموا حتى تروا الحلال ولا تفطروا حتى تروه فإن غم عليكم فاخبروا له. It's repeated again in Sahih al-Bukhari, book 30, hadith 10. It says, إذا رأيتموه فسموا وإذا رأيتموه ففطروا فإن غم عليكم فاخبروا له. And similar hadith in Sahih Muslim, it says, إذا رأيتموه فسموا وإذا رأيتموه ففطروا وإن أغمي عليكم فعدوا ثلاثين. So he said, if you sight the moon, which is the moon of Ramadan, that you should fast. And when you sight the moon, which is the moon of Shawwal, you should stop your fast, you should break your fast. And it seems unclear, the sky is unclear and you couldn't see the moon, then you should act on estimation. You should fast 30 in Ramadan. You should fast complete 30. Alhamdulillah, the Muslim faithfuls, we fast through the month of Ramadan. Now the month of Ramadan has gone. What next? Are we to go back to our ways, our fashal sins? No. We need to adopt the characters which we have held firm with in the month of Ramadan. And lastly, the talking on the sixth fast of Shawwal, which is now set of Shawwal, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said in several hadiths, in Lughul Maram, Mu'tawa Imam Malik, in Sahih Muslim, Sahih Bukhari, saying, من صوم رمضان ثم أتبعه ستة من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. What is my difference in different hadiths, but all mean the same, all trying to pass the same message. We say, whoever fasts in the month of Ramadan and then follow it up with six fastings in the month of Shawwal, it's like he has fasted the word here you use here is dah. And dah means epoch, a long time period. Could mean lifetime. But the scholars, as anonymously agreed, and with the logical calculation that every good deed is multiplied by 10. And so the Ramadan fast, which is a month, when you multiply it by 10, it gives 10 months. And then the 6 days of Shawwal multiplied by 10, that is 60 days. And 60 days is equivalent to 2 months. So 10 months plus 2 months, which is 12. So that year has been translated to mean a year, which is 12 months.
So whoever fasts the month of Ramadan and follow it up with 6 days fasting in Shawwal, succeeds as fasted for a full year. Now, so you might ask, are we to fast immediately after Ramadan, in the middle of Shawwal, in the end of it? Whichever time was not specific, how we should be fasted was not specific, but the process was not specific, and how you should fast it. So you can fast it in the beginning, if it was there, we ask it in the middle or the end, whichever way you want to fast it,
no problem.
It's nawafil fast. So we pray Allah for steadfast in the deen, purify our intentions, and grant us the best of this world and the hereafter. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum.